Hi, Kadir. Thanks for coming in today to share your experiences in China.
I'm happy to be here.
Have you been using your 30-second pitch?
你好，李老师，我是 Kadir Lim 领嘉宾。以前我在一家国际对冲基金 Indus Capital 和花旗银行 Citigroup 工作。我有法律和金融双学历，也获得了 CFA 的资格。
Impressive. 你说得很棒。Can you share some business situations where your Mandarin skills were an advantage?
Sure. A key part of my job is to meet senior management of listed companies and assess their strategies, their outlook, and then determine what it means for their share prices. Therefore, being able to communicate effectively in Mandarin with Chinese CEOs, CFOs, and senior management is critical in performing my roles well.
Can you elaborate on how Finance Mandarin has helped you in performing your role?
For non-native speakers, conducting meetings in Mandarin with top management of mainland firms can be quite daunting, with a whole host of uncertainties hanging over your head, such as, am I going to be able to build a rapport with them? Am I expressing myself in a way where they can fully understand what I'm getting at, and vice versa? Ultimately, the most important thing for me is how productive will the meeting be. This is where the Finance Mandarin program really helps. The experienced coach can quickly grasp the key issues that need to be dealt with in a meeting and help frame the questions and follow-up questions in Mandarin in a succinct and precise manner that ensure the meetings will be high quality and as productive as possible.
Your meetings have become more valuable as a result?
Yes, that's right.
And what about other advantages?
As many would agree, business knowledge often equates to business opportunity. And this is especially so in China with its ever-changing business and cultural landscape. If one is able to stay abreast of these changes, it will help you to identify new business opportunities ahead of others. Finance Mandarin program definitely adds value in this regard. With their market snippets, business news articles, and short video clips that can be accessed anywhere, anytime, Vian and team proactively bring attention to latest developments in China, not just in politics and business, but also the latest cultural and consumer trends that people in the English-speaking community may not get exposed to until much later. And this can be a huge advantage. One good example is tourism in Thailand, which we all know has been huge in the past 4 to 5 years due to mainland tourists. However, this trend actually started taking shape and became obvious as far back as 2011,had one taken note of the smashing success of a locally made Chinese movie. Another example is the explosive growth of online live streaming industry in the past 2 years, but that was already much talked about in the Chinese media going back to 2014 and 15. I really appreciate the support you and Finance Mandarin has given me over the years, Vian.
We are proud of your investment and success. Thanks, Kadir.
Originally, it was the head of equity research at JP Morgan who recommended me to go with Finance Mandarin, and I've been very happy with the investment. With a strategic action plan of the teaching team at Finance Mandarin and 8 weeks of study, I finally achieved one of my goals and passed level 6 of the HSK exam.